Hello children, how are you? Now again we are here to learn something new topic of our chapter atoms. Okay, now today we are going to see origin of spectral lines. Origin of spectral lines. Origin of spectral lines we are going to learn here. In our last module we have seen the total energy of an electron in a Bohr stationary orbit that we have been calculated in our last module. Origin of spectral lines at room temperature. At room temperature, we know very well at room temperature most of the hydrogen atoms are in a ground state. At room temperature most of the hydrogen atoms are at ground state. When a hydrogen atom receives some energy by a process such as electron collision or by a heat, then what happens? When it receives energy, the atoms may acquire sufficient energy to raise the electrons to higher energy state, say from n is equal to 1 to n is equal to 2, 3, other next orbit. So 1 to 2 and 1 to 3, atom at that time is called an excited state. Atom at that time is called excited state. So my dear children, I can say from the excited state, the electron can fall back to the lower energy state, can fall back to a state of lower energy, emitting a photon of a particular energy. Say I can draw a figure and explain it is very clearly. I can say, suppose this is our nucleus, this is the higher energy or states. Say I can say when it is coming from outer orbit, say of energy E2 to an inner energy of state E1, then it will emit a photon. Say here a photon of energy E is equal to h nu. Photon of energy h nu. Okay. So my dear children, I can say E1 is the total energy of the electron in the inner orbit. This is our inner orbit, say N1. E2 is the total energy of the electron in the outer orbit, say N2. Here it is N2. Draw the figure. So when the electron can fall back to a state of lower energy, emitting thereby a photon of a particular energy, that is the difference in the energy of the two states. Is that clear? Yes sir. Write down. So I can say here, when an electron jumps from an outer to an inner orbit, the energy of radiation emitted, according to the Bohr's third postulate, I can write h nu. H nu is equal to E2 minus E1. Say it is our equation number 1. Write down. So H nu comes out to be E2 minus E1. Is it clear? Yes. So I can say, I know the formula of energy. Use that formula. H nu comes is equal to E2. Put it here, minus 2 pi square एम के स्क्वायर जेड स्क्वायर ई की पावर 4 डिवाइडेड बाई n2 square h square। सिमिलरली फॉर n2 square h square -e1 तो -- प्लस 2π² mk² z² e की पावर 4 डिवाइडेड बाई n1 square h square। राइट डाउन दिस फॉर्मूला, यू नो एनर्जी वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड अर्लियर। हियर न्यू इज इक्वल टू आई कैन राइट c by lambda एंड वी कैन टेक कॉमन 2π² mk² z² e की पावर 4 डिवाइडेड बाई h² इफ आई टेक कॉमन, हियर आई विल गेट 1/n1² / 1/n2² इज दैट क्लियर? राइट डाउन। तो हियर डियर चिल्ड्रन यू कैन राइट h/λ इज दिस वन, तो आई कैन से 1/λ इज इक्वल टू सी एंड एच, नीचे ले लीजिए 2π² एम के स्क्वायर जेड स्क्वायर ई की पावर 4 डिवाइडेड बाई CH³ 1/n1² / 1/n2² दिस इज देयर। राइट डाउन यस, तो वी कैन से 1/λ इज इक्वल टू 2π² mk² दिस इज। राइट डाउन हियर 1/λ इज इक्वल टू, आई कैन राइट 1/λ इज इक्वल टू न्यू बार, दैट इज द वेव नंबर ऑफ रेडिएशन एमिटेड। दिस इज द वेव नंबर ऑफ रेडिएशन एमिटेड और नंबर ऑफ कंप्लीट वेव इन यूनिट लेंथ, नंबर ऑफ कंप्लीट वेव, नंबर ऑफ कंप्लीट वेव हियर वी कैन से नंबर ऑफ कंप्लीट वेव इन यूनिट लेंथ, इन यूनिट लेंथ इज दैट क्लियर? राइट डाउन हियर, तो 1/λ दैट इज आई कैन से, नाउ यू कैन राइट हियर इन दिस मैनर आर इज इक्वल टू दैट इज 2π² एम के स्क्वायर ई की पावर 4 डिवाइडेड बाई सी एच क्यू दिस इज कॉल्ड रिडबर्ग कॉन्स्टेंट। हियर यू कैन राइट एंड अ कॉन्स्टेंट कॉल्ड रिडबर्ग कॉन्स्टेंट। सो आई कैन से पुटिंग दिस वैल्यू ऑफ वेरियस टर्म्स इन दिस रिलेशन वी विल गेट all are constant. If I am writing here 2π m k e 4, then I will get r is equal to 1.097 into 10^7 meter inverse. This is there. If you put all the values here, then we can write the new bar comes out to be r z² 1/n² -1/n2² दिस इज द फॉर्मूला हियर फॉर द हाइड्रोजन एटम। आई नो वेरी वेल द वैल्यू ऑफ जेड इज इक्वल टू 1 फॉर द हाइड्रोजन एटम। आई कैन से फॉर हाइड्रोजन एटम जेड इज इक्वल टू 1। राइट डाउन when you put z is equal to 1 here, so you will get nu bar is equal to only r 1/n1² -1/n2² here. This is the formula. This is called Rydberg formula. This formula is called Rydberg formula for the spectrum of hydrogen atom. This is called Rydberg formula for an hydrogen atom. Is that clear? Write down. we can see clearly here the wavelength. We can see clearly here the wavelength, frequency, wave number of radiation emitted by an excited hydrogen atom, are not continuous. We are not getting the continuous spectra. Is it clear? We have seen over there that this is not continuous. They have a specific value depending upon the values of N1 and N2. It's totally depend on these. Here I am going to explain this. That is the Bohr explanation of a spectral series of hydrogen atom. I am going to explain Bohr's explanation of an hydrogen atom. Let us see here. Long before a scientist named Bohr, he gave a theory of hydrogen atom. Various scientists had observed experimentally, but theoretically it is proved by Bohr's. Experimentally to kahi unhe dekha, but theoretically it has been proved by Bohr. Theoretical explanation of these spectral series. First, that is Lyman series. First one is, it is Lyman series. Here, in the Lyman series, Bohr postulated that Lyman series is obtained when an hydrogen atom, when an electron jumps from N1 is equal to 1, 2, N2 is equal to 2, 3, 4 state. From first orbit to the second, or first to the third, we can say electron jumps to the first orbit from any outer orbits 2, 3, 1, 2 se 1 mein, 3 se 1 mein, 4 se 1 mein. That is called Lyman series, and we can calculate it here. Let us see here. Wave number of spectral series of Lyman were calculated by this formula. Nu bar is equal to R 1 by N1 की जगह लिखिए 1 square minus 1 by K square. Here that is K is equal to 2, 3, 4 like this. So we can say this value of nu bar lies here in the ultraviolet region. This is in the region called ultraviolet region. Here. Ultraviolet region of the spectrum and agrees well with the values obtained experimentally by the Lyman. Lyman ne jo experimentally dekha, wo theoretically Bohr ne explain kar diya. Is it clear? Write down. This is Lyman series. Then after that, the Balmer series is there. The second one is Balmer series. The second one is Balmer series, or we can say in the Balmer series, according to the Balmer and according to Bohr, Balmer series is obtained when an electron jumps to the second orbit. Electron jumps to the second orbit from an outer orbit, N2 is equal to 3, 4, 5 like this. Third to second, fourth to second, and five to second like this. So electron jumps to the second orbit from any outer orbit. So wave number of these spectral lines were calculated by this formula. Nu bar is equal to R 1 by 2 square minus 1 by K square. When K is equal to 3, 4, 5 like this here. So we can say the set of spectral lines lies in the visible part of the spectrum. That is available in the visible part of the spectrum. That is available in the visible part of the spectrum. Write down. This is the visible part of the spectrum that were calculated by Bosch and it is experimentally result obtained by Wammer and theoretically by Bosch. Now, the next one is the next series that we are going to see, that is Paschen series. Third one is Paschen series. Yeah. So now we are going to learn Paschen series. In Paschen series, according to the Bohr, Paschen series is obtained when an electron jumps to the third orbit from any other outer orbit 4, 5, 6 like this. So I can say Paschen series is obtained when an electron jumps to the third orbit. Electron jumps to the third orbit from any other outer orbit, say from 4, 5 and 6 like that. And the Bohr calculated the wave number nu bar is equal to r 1 by 3 square minus 1 by k square. So I can say k here is equal to 4, 5 like this. So this is there. These value of the nu bar lies in the infrared region. This lies in the infrared region. Where is that? This lies in the infrared region. Okay? Of the spectrum and everywhere with the values of nu bar observed experimentally by the Paschen. Observed experimentally by the Paschen. Okay? Yes. Write down. Then the next series, that is bracket. The next series that we are going to see, that is bracket. Here. Bracket series, according to Bohr, bracket series is obtained when an electron jumps to the inner orbit, that is fourth orbit, from any other outer orbit, say from 5, 6, 7 like this. So n1 is equal to 4 and n2 is equal to 5, 6, 7 like this from here to here. Fourth to an outer orbit 5, 6, 7. Then the last series, that is Pund series. The Pund series according to the Bosch, Pund series is obtained when an electron jumps in a fifth orbit from any other outer orbit 6, 7 like this. So these are the different series theoretically observed by Bohr. Is it clear? Yes sir. Write down. So various spectral series of hydrogen atom can be represented by a diagram. Here we are going to draw a diagram. Let us see. Here, say our nucleus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this. Draw these circles. Here, say our nucleus. N is equal to 1. Here n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, n is equal to 4, n is equal to 5, n is equal to 6 like this, and n is equal to 7 here. In the first series, we can say, what is our first series name? That is Lyman series. In the Lyman series, electron jumps to the first orbit from any other outer orbit, here to here. 2 to 1, 3 to 1, 4 to 1 like this. 2 to 1, 3 to 1, 4 to 1. This is called Lyman series. Here. Draw this. from second orbit to the first orbit, third orbit to the first orbit, like this. Now, then what is the Balmer series in the second orbit? Here, third to second, fourth to second, fifth to second, like this. This is called Balmer series. Here, this is called Balmer series. Paschen series from fourth to third, here. Fourth to third, fifth to third, like this. Line 1, Balmer, this is Paschen. These we can draw in the diagram. This various spectral series of hydrogen atom can be represented like this. This is the Paschen, then bracket EF. Fifth to fourth in this manner. Yeah. This is bracket. This is the bracket. Okay. And what is Kund in fifth? 6 to 5th, 7 to 5th, like this. This is Kund series. This is Kund series. Draw this diagram. This is called spectral series of hydrogen atom. Here. Draw this diagram. Now I want to draw an energy level diagram. I want to draw here an energy level diagram. Energy level diagram. What is that? Here I am going to draw the energy level diagram. Energy level diagram. Energy level diagram. What is that? A diagram which represents the total energy of an electron. A diagram that represents the total energy. Total energy of an electron, total energy of an electron in different stationary orbit, in different stationary orbit, in different stationary orbit, total energy of an electron in different stationary orbit of an atom, of an atom is called energy level diagram, is called energy level diagram of an hydrogen atom, energy level diagram of that atom. In this diagram I can say the total energy of the electron, total energy of an electron, in this energy level diagram, the total energy of an electron in various stationary orbit, in various stationary orbit, in various stationary orbit, are represented by, are represented by parallel oriented lines, parallel horizontal lines that we are going to draw. Write down parallel horizontal lines drawn according to some suitable energy scale that we are going to draw. First you write down this, the energy level diagram, that is the total energy of an electron in different stationary orbit. Yes, so now I am going to draw here. I can say, just I am going to draw a diagram here. Let us see, this is the Lyman series. Here this represents n is equal to 1. Here the energy level, the scale here is, say it is minus 14, here it is minus 13, just to draw the scale here. 12, then n is equal to 2, suppose here, it is n is equal to 2, this n is equal to 1 for Lyman. N is equal to 2, that is Palmer. This is in the range in between minus 4 to minus 3. Then Pasteur, n is equal to 3. Here it is Pasteur. That is in the range of Pasteur, that is in the range of minus 2 to minus 1 here. Then bracket fund like this. Then bracket fund here. N is equal to 1, 2, 3, N is equal to 4, N is equal to 5. Just to draw this. In this manner I can say, when an electron jumps from second orbit to the first orbit, here in this manner, here like this, this is called Lyman series. Here you can say from here, here like this, this is Balmer series. Similarly here something like this, here. These are the energy level diagram. Draw this figure. It is represented by oriental lines. We can say like this. At infinity, here, n is equal to infinity. Here the energy is zero. Just to draw this diagram, then I am going to explain. These vertical lines connecting any two states represents the transition of electrons from one to the other of these states. These lines represent transition of electrons. Here. Difference of energies of the two states gives here and here, gives the amount of energy emitted, amount of energy emitted or absorbed according as the electron goes from the higher energy state to a lower energy state or from a lower to higher energy level. Okay, these are representing in this manner. So I can say, my dear children, here the total energy of electrons in nth orbit of hydrogen atom is represented by E is equal to minus 2 pi square m k square e to power 4 divided by n square h square. This is the energy. This is E. On substituting the standard values, I can get minus 13.6 divided by n square electron volt. Put all the values here. Putting n is equal to 1, 2, 3, you will get the values of E1 here. That is minus 13.6 divided by 1 square, that is minus 13.6 electron volt. This is here for n is equal to 1. For n is equal to 2, put here n is equal to 2, you will get minus 3.4 electron volt here. In between 3 and 4, that is Balmer series. E3 you will get minus 1.51 electron volts. These are the standard values. We can calculate it with this formula. Here. This is the total energy here. So what I am telling here, the difference of energy of the two states gives the amount of energy. Amount of energy emitted or absorbed according as the electron goes from higher to the lower energy state or from lower to the higher energy level. Yes. So my dear children, I can say Similarly, E4, E5, E6, you can calculate here. So I can say E1, E2, E3, both. You can calculate. Now, as n increases, जैसे n बढ़ेगा, E n becomes less negative. You can see. जैसे n की वैल्यू बढ़ेगी, स्टेट की वैल्यू बढ़ेगी, लेस नेगेटिव. Until n is equal to infinity, En becomes zero. Yes. So these are the energy level diagram. Is that clear? So this is the energy of the atom when electron is completely removed from r is equal to infinity from the nucleus and the electrons is at rest. So highest energy state corresponding to n is equal to infinity. And at that time the energy is zero. ये क्या चीज है? This is the energy of the atom. What is this? This is the energy of the atom when the electron is completely removed. That is r is equal to infinity. From the atom and the electrons is at rest. And the electron is at rest. Is that clear? So today module is complete. Okay, bye.